Ooh, that's a man. Okay. So, here's the thing is that... Hey, everybody. Let me tweet real quick that what I'm playing is Mountain Blade and not Pokemon Nuzlocke. All right. Hey, what's up, guys? So, here's the thing is that... Remember that Star Wars Mountain Blade game? That's the only Mountain Blade that I ever played, even though I've owned Mountain Blade and Mountain Blade Warband since then. And I'm just going to create a character because that's like my favorite shit to do. What's up? Okay, face ratio. I don't know what that means. Okay, so this is... So you've never seen how sliders work. So you start in the middle and, okay, normal. And then you get less than normal, more than normal. That's how it's your basic slider config. Yeah, I decided that I gotta play something with a horse in it. Oh, he's sad. This is the one to make him sad. This is the one to make him mad. One second, guys. I had to turn on the volume because the game's like really loud for me. And the volume mixer. Let's see. Delilah says, Keith, congrats, I noticed the world isn't suffering from the advent of a Dark Lord. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what you're talking about. Anyway, so I have this face. Oh, this is the way to have his eyes, impede his eyeballs. That's fun. See, this, look at his face, what's this? See, that's him being... A creep. That's what I remember being in first grade and having a friend that would do that with his eyelids. But this guy's just like that. It's just different. I feel like, besides the messed up eyes, this guy looks really peasant. He looks like general fantasy peasant right now. Let's fix the eyelids. I don't want to do that to him. I don't want to make him have to look like that. Wouldn't have been fair. Dead eyes. Really dead. Really unhealthy eyes he's got. If he made a sound, he can't talk, but he can make this sound. Slightly upturned, but not long. A little bit wider. A little bit up there. Some cheeks. What's going on with the cheeks? Very gaunt, not gaunt. Let's go slightly gaunt. Really wide mouth. You know what they say about a wide mouth? Wide mouth, good with the sword. I'm going to do something to... Oh, no, 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 no. Maybe. No, though. Let's get something good with the hair. Although this doesn't seem like a good hair sort of game. Yeah, it's none of these are really speaking to me. looks like an orc from the side. Yeah, what is this? Is this? There we go. Cybert says, have you played Mountain Blade before? I played a weird Star Wars Total Conversion mod for the first Mountain Blade, but I've never actually played real Mountain Blade. It worked exactly the same. Like, to the point where blaster rifles had, like, they would sink like bows. I'm actually already pretty satisfied with how this guy looks. I think I'm probably not going to have any facial hair. Probably going to go sans facial hair. Maybe that. Maybe some. Let's get some scruff. That makes sense. Ooh. Well, obviously sunfish. Duh. Wow. Wow. You guys, a lot of people are playing Mountain Blade still. Unless this is just an error. Let's see when this gets to zero. Let's go. Oh, is that it? Wow, a lot of people. Oh, okay, these have zero. Well, this has zero players. Well, duh, let's play this. Let's play this one that has 155 players in it. No. Ugh, that's annoying. How about this? Connect. All right, well, what does this mean? All right, how do I be in game, please? All right, it says I'm a spectator. Oh, I guess I'm just still downloading the map. What is going on? None of these players look like they're fighting. I like this sword, though. It's, like, broken at the end. That's dope. It's dope as all heck. How do I know? Oh, what? Okay, no bigotry and racism. Got it. Choose a faction. I guess I'll be this one. And I guess I'll be an infantry, and I guess I'll be this, and I guess I'll be this, and I guess I'll be this, and then I guess I'll be this, and then I guess I'll be this. I don't know. I don't know what I just did. Do you? When do I be playing? Oh, that's me. This is me. All right. Which ones are the bad ones? Which ones are the bad... How do I know who's the bad one? Okay, this one's a bad one. Or no? Oh, are they down here? They're all just down here.
Stop!
How do I know? I'll take my... Are you a friend? Friend or foe? How do I know? Ha! You missed. Someone tried to get me, but missed. Oh, there you are. There's the bet. Oh, I win. I beat that guy. I'm good. Alright, well, this is a lot. No, I died. Okay, but now I know how to tell which ones are bad. It's the ones that try to get you. Well, here's how I do this now. So, alright, so I'm back. Oh, hey there. How do I use that? Well, I got shot in the head. I got shot right in the head. I'll get it. I'll get this, you guys. While we're waiting, let's talk about this. Have you been to hayt.me yet? Have you done that? Check that out. You could go on iTunes. You could get episode 3 of How Are You Today? The comedy podcast I started a year of, did 2 episodes of, and then couldn't afford to do more of. You can subscribe to that. You can review it. Oh, now I'm back in. All right, I killed one. Oh, man.
Is this Dark Souls? What are you playing?
Hey, Allie, what's up? I'm playing Mountain Blade Warband.
Hi.
The Dark Souls of Dark Souls.
Don't make that joke.
It's true. Well, the one defining feature of Dark Souls is that it's hard and obtuse.
Okay,
This is that to literally every possible extreme.
I think there are other features of Dark Souls, but sure.
Not according to memes.
Right.
Allie, how do I switch weapons?
Why?
I'm on a controller. I mean, I'm on a keyboard.
Shift?
I killed two guys. Guess what? I've killed two people.
Two whole guys.
Yeah.
That seems like not very many. How many have you fought?
Like 4.
I guess I've never killed anyone in my life, so 2 people is a lot.
This is a hardy man. Alright, here we go. How do I... Ooh, first person. That's what you want. How do I switch weapons to my big pole thing? Look at all these arrows. Those shouldn't be like that, huh?
Who's shooting at you?
It's everyone. There's 80 people. 40 on 40.
40 on 40?
Yeah, it's too many, right?
Where's the other 39 guys?
They're all over the place. See them all around? Oh, I'm not screen sharing with you, so I should do that.
No. Yeah, I'm just watching.
Oh,
wait,
I can't. Can I do that?
No, I don't think so. I think we switched to...
I died. There's fall damage and I died from it.
Where are you? Why are there palm trees? Wait, did you fall on stairs?
I fell off of the stairs.
Okay, right, okay.
I was up here.
Right.
And I jumped. I was like, oh, I can make that. That's like 4 feet. But no, I died. It killed me.
Yeah.
So anybody listening, Allie here is on Friends at the Table with me. And
hello.
When we were doing Stream Friends was also one of those.
I was one of those, and you weren't, so...
I wasn't, but I was doing them.
Yeah, you were there a lot. That's true. You were there a lot.
The poll is rejected by the majority. I didn't realize there was a story to the game. Is the Mountain Blade experts in the chat, is the way to play this game first person, or should I go back to different person?
The way to play this game is the Star Wars mod. I don't even know why you're wasting your time.
100%. I want to know, well, because I don't have that installed, and it's too difficult to get running.
That's fair.
That's right. Sear says, I'm supporting Keith through HAYT.me. Are you? Are you?
I'm not yet.
Not you, Allie. I was talking to, to the crowd.
Oh, but the crowd should. That's a really good show.
It's really good.
It's a really good podcast.
It is.
Takes a lot of work.
I've had people say that they fell down listening to it.
No, that was just the one person.
I had two people say that.
That was just the one. That was
I
just
had
spam.
Two people.
That was just
spam. No, it was two.
That was just the one.
Two.
Okay, sure.
And then I had someone say that it was the funniest podcast that I've heard in a long time.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
A long time.
Yeah. I've had people, there are even nicer things, but clearly Allie just won't believe me if I say them. So. Alright, I'm dead again.
You guys should definitely support Keith, though. Like, making a podcast is actually really hard.
It's, super hard, and this is a particularly hard one to do.
Yeah. For Friends at the Table, for every, 1 hour of podcast, it takes me 2 hours to edit it.
Yeah.
But, for
How are you today
do...
for every 1 hour of podcast, it takes me, four or 5 hours of production?
Because you're just doing so much with it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of editing. I usually end up cutting out about half of the recorded content, but not full segments, tiny bits and pieces from different things. It's very annoying.
Comedy is hard.
Yeah. Who are all these men, and why do I hate them so much? What's my motivation?
Yeah, I guess you're in a war. There's a poll happening?
Yes, there was a poll.
Did you?
It was rejected by the majority.
Oh,
and so I guess that's just it.
Okay, well, all right. Do you know why you guys should support How Are You Today? Because I was on it that one time.
That's true, and you'll be on it again, probably.
You should. Oh, probably.
Probably.
Maybe.
Watch your step.
Whoa! Oh my god, wait, Keith, did you go on Twitter?
No, why? I mean,
did
ever?
Did you see what...
Yes, I have been on Twitter.
Have you ever been on Twitter? Do you have a Twitter account, Keith?
Yeah, I do have a Twitter account.
I got some
account.
Good tweets on there.
Yeah, it's at
some funny
Keith
jokes.
J. Carberry.
No, okay, so I ordered a Sicilian pie, right? Because you were having that big argument.
The big argument about how you're a dumb jerk that fucking prefers crustless centerpieces of a square pizza to actual shaped pizza with crust. You prefer the non-crust slices of an already inferior shape.
Yeah.
Okay.
No. And oh, my God. Okay,
that made me so mad, by the way. It made me so mad that I bought a real shaped pizza. I swear to God, I went to Dedham Hazard Pizza and I bought a large buffalo chicken pizza.
Well, you want to hear some shit, Keith?
Sure, what's up?
I ordered a Sicilian pie from a local pizza place and it was an 8-slice pie. There was no middle pieces.
See, that's the way to do it. If you're going to do a square pie...
No!
Because my real qualm with the square pizza is that there are slices in the middle that don't have crust. And it's not only is it... I understand someone that's saying, oh, I don't like crust. But what I don't understand is someone saying, I would rather balance a slice of pizza on 3 fingers trying not to get sauce and bullshit all over my hands than just don't eat the crust.
It's really not that hard.
It's not that hard to not eat the crust.
It's really not that hard.
It is. It's. Yeah. There's no way to pick it up without putting your fucking thumb up against some cheese. There's no way. There's no way.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
No, you can't. It's impossible.
Oh my god.
I saw
I've
a study.
Clearly been doing this
I read
longer
it
than
on
you
Slate.
Have. Oh my
I
god.
I read it on Slate and The Guardian and Snopes. And all of them said that you can't pick up a fucking square piece of pizza with no crust without getting some cheese on you. They all said that.
And Snopes.
Yeah, and Snopes.
I can't argue with Snopes.
Yeah.
I really can't. Goodness. Yeah, okay, I guess you're right. If Snopes said so, I guess you're right. Fuck.
Yeah, I guess I am right. Like, I don't know what the... Like, I'm not surprised.
Yes. Anyway, that's what happened to me today. And I'm very upset.
How was the pizza, though?
It was pretty good. It wasn't bad.
By Sicilian pizza, do you mean, like, that's just the shape of the pizza? Or was this, like, it had Italian meats on it?
No, it's just that's what you call it.
Well, I have seen Sicilian pizzas, circle ones that are called that because they have Italian meats on it.
Oh, that's weird and not right.
You're weird and not right. Burn.
Subscribe
at hayt.me. Burn. That's the sort of shit you can get.
Keith, in case you think that I'm the only person.
I know. I work with
your...
I worked at a pizza place.
Okay,
no, fine. I'll let you talk. You're right. I'm being unfair.
Oh my god. Oh my god, Keith.
I already said I'm being unfair. It's fine. You go. I'm being unfair. I'm not letting you talk. So you just go.
In case you think that you're the only person that I have these sorts of arguments with, once I had like a screaming argument with a friend, not screaming, but it was this type of argument with a friend of mine over whether you call Sicilian slices or square slices. And I was like, no, you go to a pizza place that says Sicilian on the menu. Like, what are you even talking about?
To be fair to that person, Sicilian as the shape of the pizza, I think, is a New York thing.
Yeah.
Or at least
Brooklyn.
It's a regional thing.
He's from Brooklyn.
Well, I don't know. I don't have... I'm just saying... I'm just giving you the most generous possible read.
Okay. I appreciate that, I guess. Instead
Delilah
of you just being on my side.
Delilah asked if I can take out the big stick, and I don't know how to do that. I know that I can, because I chose it as equipment, and I have tried so hard and could not figure it out.
Did you try shift?
I didn't. I might have. I can't remember. I'll let you know in 7 seconds.
Okay.
Seer says, Keith, please stop bullying Al. You do not enough of that on Friends of the Table. That is a severe misread of the situation, if that's what you think.
What?
Is that I'm bullying Allie.
Yeah, that's all you do.
No.
That's literally all you do.
You're the one that bullies me.
What?
See, this is why I miss Stream Friends. Stream Friends was where I could go for everybody to feel bad for me. I don't want other people getting that. Because it's unearned.
It's unearned?
Yeah.
What?
I have...
Keith is so mean to me, and now he's saying that, like, people aren't allowed to feel bad for me while he abuses me live on his own channel.
Listen, you didn't have to go on. You were just fucking... square slices.
So, to be real here, we have, like, a Discord channel with some friends of ours, and I was like, hey, do you guys all want to hang out to play this game? And you were like, yeah, but I'm gonna stream this thing first, or I'm just gonna take up the voice channel. You guys can just hop in if you want.
Just make a new voice channel. It's unlimited voice channels. There's another one right next to it.
Just saying.
How do I switch? Oh, okay, hold on. First, let's get out of here.
Apparently switch with the mouse wheel. Do you have one of those?
Yeah, that's all it does is put away my fucking... All it does is put away my, shield. The poll is rejected by the majority. Oh, I accidentally sent a message instead of defending myself.
Do you vote in that poll?
I don't know how to. I don't notice the polls until they're over.
You gotta make your voice heard, Keith.
That's true. It's my
voting
civic duty.
Voting is so important.
It's super important. I mean, it's not... It's important. It's like the only thing that's important but not effective.
Yeah, I don't know.
Up on the wheel. Oh, there we go. Now I've got this thing. Now I can jab.
Jab? Ooh.
I bet I can get that horseman.
Is
I bet
like
I can get
a,
that horseman.
What's above you? Is that like a nice picture of like a...
That is a sky.
No. You Palm fucking tree? Bitch.
Sorry.
You fucking bitch.
Well, listen, there's a time delay.
No, okay, so like 3 minutes before this, there was like a gold cat with a red background above you.
Oh, that
you.
Sounds nice. I wish I had seen it.
Yeah. Oh yeah, just the sky that's above me. You fucking... God.
Listen, all those fucking first grade jokes, those are coming back.
Yeah?
Yep. I'm just swinging this pike. Is this a pike? This is a halberd? What's the difference between a pike and a halberd?
Oh, you were asking the wrong person. What's a halberd?
It's like a pike, I think.
We have fun here.
Yeah.
Oh, we have a good time.
Yeah. Listen, so... HAYT.me. You supporting there? Yeah, good. How about contentburger.biz? How about that? You there too? Are you over there?
Maybe
how
do,
about
maybe do them both.
How about fuckdads.com? You downloaded some of my music yet? You done that?
So here's the thing.
What?
For all you fans out there, just because it's me and Keith right now, we can kind of get real.
Yeah.
It's a run button channel, but we can kind of speak. You know, if you
sure
been
fuck
a fan,
Kyle is what you're saying, right?
If you've been a fan of Run Run for a while, but, like, you really only follow it because Keith is good and, like, Kyle's okay, I don't want to, you know, Kyle's alright, but you really just like Keith, maybe just take the money that you're putting towards Run Button.
Wait,
just
no, don't
to
do
how
that.
Are you today?
Don't do that.
Because it's just going to go right to Keith.
I'll give you a few reasons to not do that. First of all, Kyle will be very upset.
No, he wouldn't know. It's fine.
He would. Well, I mean, it's not that he wouldn't know. It's that he would find out. Second of all, I think if there was a mass contentburger.biz exodus, and then all of a sudden my podcast was raking in hundreds, I think he would figure something out. Second is that the money that comes, you can spend more on contentburger.biz. So I get half of 92% of like $9 donations, where from How Are You Today I'm getting all of 89% of like $4 donations. So it works out to be about the same.
Couple things here.
Yeah.
A, I can't believe that you think it would be a mass exodus from Contentburger.
You're saying if someone were to go like you only like Keith, right? You don't think it would be a mass exodus?
I think you would get a few like dozen. I don't think it would be a mass exodus.
I think everybody. Well, listen, everybody's here. They're all listening. 180 people in the chat right now. Not true.
This is true.
26.
This is true. B, what was I going to say? You don't have to disclose to Kyle how much your podcast is making. It's just your podcast. He doesn't need to know that after the mass exodus happens that you're raking it in. 3, does PayPal really take that big of a cut?
What's that?
Does PayPal takes an 11% cut
okay,
of all your
so,
donations?
So what happens with PayPal is they take... they take 2.5% plus 30 cents. And because the amounts are so small, that works out to being kind of a lot of money. I'm in the process of switching it to being, I'm in the process of switching it to like their micropayments setting, which is they take a bigger percent but a much smaller, like, it's like 5%, but like 10 cents per transaction, which ends up being, instead of like 20%, like 8% total.
PayPal is weirdly, like, weird and bad, but it's, like, the only thing that anyone can ever use, ever.
I died. Yeah, I was gonna take the time to do, I was talking to you about this, to code a front end for a Stripe payment system, but I just didn't have time to get it done, and I did the calculations, and I was like, you know what, it's totally worth it for me to just suck it up and use PayPal. Like the Wix like e-commerce thing that I'm using to actually do the donations through, they don't take a cut at all, which is nice. And I think right now they take 11%, I think is what they're at. Which isn't
what?
Right, but that's before I switch to micropayments. So after that goes through, I just have to call them to like confirm my identity or something. And then it'll go down from 11% to, like, 8%, which is comparatively pretty good. It's bad because most... The way that How Are You Today is being funded is $2, $4, and $6 donations, and I've got things in the works to set up, like, hey, you can pay what you want for, like, stuff that I had to cut out. Like, you can just download it for free or also give me, like, a buck or two for it. But... The way that most payment systems work is they take a percentage and also a flat rate, which is brutal on small dollar donations. And so the fact that PayPal has their, they have the micropayments option is like, makes it immediately way better. Stripe, again, would have been the best option, but I just didn't have the time to like code a fucking thing in Python and figure out how to implement it properly. Like I just didn't.
Websites.
Yeah, because I spent 4 days in a row total. Going to work from 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. and then coming home and working on Friends of the Table, or not Friends of the Table, on How Are You Today until 4 in the morning. And I was just like that was without doing the Stripe thing, so.
Yeah, it's tough. It's hard. It's really hard to be, like, a content creator.
It is. I was just tweeting about how weird it is, like, the way, like, the places that the money I make comes from. Like, it doesn't make, like, it's weird, because I've got a huge amount, not a huge amount, I have the biggest amount coming from a run button from the contentburger.biz site, and then, like, a bunch of stuff that I do for free, like Friends of the Table, and then, like, probably, like, $5 to $15 dollars a month from just like people that happen to buy fuckdads.com tracks. And then like the marathons that we do, or people just like randomly donating to our PayPal account, and then also now How Are You Today. It's just like a fucking weird, really decentralized thing. I don't know, it's super weird. Stuff's weird. How do I do anything? Where's my sword? There we go. Glorp says you give this a few hundred more years and you'll be able to make a living. I think I could do it faster than that. I mean, it was only 2 years ago that I was making $0, right? And now it's like, I pay basically my rent, my whole rent.
Oh, was that was how long ago you guys did a Run Button Patreon?
Yeah, it was March of 2014, I think.
So up until that, you were just like...
Making YouTube money. By the way, also I forgot that I'm making like $40 a month from YouTube ads. I've talked to Kyle about this. I would really love to take off literally all of our YouTube ads and just only do like the Game Wisp. I bet there are people that like would go, oh, you're not doing ads anymore, I will now subscribe.
Yeah.
I mean,
maybe.
I did a poll on Twitter, and based on that, if everybody that said they would donate, like, and not even as a representative thing, just of the people who happened to answer this poll, if you take them at their word, we would already be making more money from doing that than having the ads. We've probably tripled our amount of views per month. This is very inside baseball, you guys. We have basically tripled our views per month since we started getting money from YouTube, and our the money that we get from them per month has gone down from 80 each to 60 each to now 35 each. And all we've gone is gone up in views and retention. So fuck YouTube ads, fuck getting money from Google. They suck. I would rather just not do ads at all. I know this is a game about realism, but I'm really sick of running out of fucking javelins.
What? You have all those arrows. Why aren't you,
I don't have any arrows.
What's in your back? Are those javelins?
Those are javelins, yeah.
Well, you're really just throwing them all willy-nilly.
I was. That time I was. But before I was aiming and stuff. I'm gonna get this guy. He doesn't even know I'm here. It's on my side.
You've been throwing all of these javelins at one of your guys.
How is I supposed to know?
You're supposed to know!
No.
You're supposed to know who your boys are.
I died. So don't go up that way, I guess. Glorp says, yeah, running out of ammo is like a main part of this game. Okay, well then I won't do that anymore. Here's the good thing about a sword. Can't run out of sword ammo.
You don't know that. The sword can break. It's not sharp anymore.
The shields break, but I don't think the swords do.
That doesn't seem very real, if you ask me.
Listen, whatever, Game of Thrones.
Excuse me?
Yeah, burn.
Game of Thrones. I'm actually offended. Actually, Alex Navarro made one of the funniest tweets that I've seen in my life today.
Oh yeah? What is that?
Yeah, which is... he said... Let me find it. It was like, I lean over to you during a climatic moment in Game of Thrones. That's the throne. And it was really funny to me.
That's pretty funny.
It's really good.
It's a stupid looking throne.
It's not great.
It doesn't look comfortable, it doesn't look kingly, it doesn't look anything. It doesn't look like
they're
anything.
They're playing all those games for that throne. They could just buy a nice looking chair.
Just buy a better throne, yeah.
Yeah. Just get it. We'll just go to a nice place and get a nice chair.
Holy shit, there's a javelin sticking out of that dude's chest.
No. What? Can you grab it?
No, I put it there.
Oh.
I mean, I still don't think I can grab it.
I mean, it's yours, right?
It is mine. I think this is a stupid game.
Oh.
We lost. Oh, whoa. See, what's this? What's going on?
Starting to think you're not very, good at war.
Well, no, I'm a pacifist.
So what are you doing? Oh, why does that man have no shirt on? You were so close to him. Is he riding a horse nude?
Why not? Get the feel of nature.
This is true.
That's how you do it.
Oh, I have to listen to the new episode of How Are You Today to hear all the blood bit.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The blood with the bit.
I don't
the
know
bit with the, all the
I
blood.
I know what you're talking about.
Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to listen to find out.
What is we doing? What are we doing?
What?
I think I'm breaking down the door, I think I'm doing the right thing.
Okay, yeah, I mean, you probably want to get into that door, right?
Everyone else is also hitting it, so I think...
Mm-hmm.
I think that's right. It said they defended their castle, but we're still attacking. I guess that's why they have 1 point up top.
You, listen. I don't know the rules.
The only rule I know is that I rule.
Well,
yep.
Furry.
That's my Game of Thrones motto. If I was a Game of Thrones. Like the only.
Oh boy. Yeah. Oh
man.
What would I do in Game of Thrones? Oh.
My arm's in a wall. You'll get there.
You'll be fine. You'll get it back. Fine. Oh.
This is not as good as Overwatch.
It isn't.
No.
Mm-mm.
It's interesting to play. I'm gonna get three kills before I die. Mark my word.
Yeah, I don't think so.
No?
Are you trying to goose someone? What are you doing?
Okay, that guy got me. That guy got me good. I didn't die. He just got me good.
I guess his rule was that he rules.
I'm dead. I died. So next time is gonna get three. I think I fucked up with the javelin thing. I just think I'm not good enough to do the javelin.
Javelins are tough.
Yes. Also, maybe I'll get back into... I was doing best in first person mode. So maybe I'll do that some more. No! Oh wow, I guess this one doesn't have as much fall damage, because before I fell off like 1 inch and I died.
Maybe you fell onto like a particularly sharp floor?
No, I'm dead.
Oh, Jordan's here to let us know that you misplayed Mountain Blade.
I don't know, it sounds right to me, Mountain Blade. What is I don't even know how I could spell that wrong.
Yeah, I'm looking at it, it seems fine.
Mountain Blade. I don't know what the...
Mountain Blade?
See? Look, mountains.
That's it.
That's it. Blade.
You got it.
Check and check. Thanks, Jordan. Mm-hmm. How are you today? Anyway. Listen, it's not cross-promotion to just greet my friend. Jordan has probably the saddest story in all of... how are you today? In that I recorded a full episode with like probably a 35 minute interview with Jordan, and then my computer died. I lost the whole episode. I was like 95% done with it.
Wait, you did that with me too.
I did that one with you too. Yep. Jordan was in there.
Yeah.
You and Jordan were in there. But Jordan had not been on it.
You
already had an episode. DVAC was also in that one. DVAC, I played a game with Art, Austin, Janine, and DVAC. And I was the host. It was called TED Talk or Not, and I read the title of a TED Talk, and you had to tell me if it was real or if I made it up.
Oh.
D-Deck 1 now.
Can I tell you something about me?
What?
So when TED Talks were being talked about a ton, was also when the movie TED... came out.
You thought the movie TED was called TED Talks?
No, I thought that all of the TED Talks were about that movie.
No, you
that
didn't.
Like yes, I did. Yes,
no,
I did.
Sorry,
every single time.
Al, you're not listening to me. No, you didn't.
Every single time someone mentioned a TED Talk, I was like, are they still doing interviews for that? Also, that doesn't seem like the kind of person who would like TED and just like. Keith, I'm telling you, like, weeks.
Wow.
Weeks of me, thank
you. And you didn't, like, you didn't want to watch one? You have any interest in, like, seeing one?
No, because I thought it was all about that movie.
Did you see the movie? Why wouldn't you want to watch fucking, a weird scientist talk about the movie TED?
Actually, oh my god, that would be incredible. What if we got together, everyone who's done a TED Talk, and interviewed them about the movie TED?
You're saying, like, would that be good, or could we do it? Because those are two different answers. Yes, it would be good. No, we could not get fucking Elon Musk and Ron Funches in the same room to talk about.
I think that we could. They wouldn't have to be in the same room. They would just be, you know.
Can someone check that for me? Has Elon Musk done a TED Talk?
That would be incredible. We should really look
into this. I remember there being a really great shift between, like, when TED Talks were a really big thing and everybody was all about them, and then when TED Talks were a really big thing and everyone was talking shit about them.
You know what? Another thing we could do. How good do you think that you could do a TED voice?
Like a Seth MacFarlane voice? Or just no, like a guy like... named Ted?
No, the Ted. The talking bear. Ted.
Not good.
The rude and crude talking bear. Ted himself. Not very good.
I mean,
good.
I think I could talk about smoking weed with Marky Wahlberg.
What we could do is have a podcast titled Ted's TED Talk, and where you, as Ted, or anyone as Ted, I'm putting a lot on you and I apologize for
I cannot do anyone. A Peter Griffin, and Ted is just Peter Griffin.
Anyone as Ted could be, like, in character as Ted, but talking about a TED Talk that they watched that week.
Like, about how we need to rethink education in America?
Uh-huh. But he would be like, yeah, that's what Ted
is. That what Ted does? He just goes, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
No.
Listen, Allie, there's we're devaluing degrees in America to the point where students are having to spend more and more money on going to school for a degree that means less and less. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that's not his catchphrase. Maybe we should get on the phone with Seth and be like, have you thought about him?
I can just offer him. Do you want me to offer someone a brewski? Can I do that?
You can do that. Yeah. Yeah.
Have you thought about how science and religion is innately connected in human spirituality? Want a brewski?
I think this idea has legs.
I think it has two stuffed legs.
Of which Ted
and a heart of gold.
The rude and crude stuffed bear.
Were you around for how mad I got when I heard what the plot of Ted 2 was?
Maybe.
The plot of Ted 2 is where Ted has to, like, go. I haven't seen it. I just heard about it.
Okay.
I was too mad about it. So it was to go and prove, like, that he's like a person, like not a human person, but like that he counts as like alive. And it was
I saw some ads for that.
Like,
yeah.
And I just the whole time I was just like, could you have a plot that is more like. The resolution is so self-evident. He's, like, talking to you in sentences, and you went to the store to get, like, yeah, he's a fucking, like, he's alive. Like, what
I
more
know,
could you want?
I'm just saying.
Yeah, but does it count?
You know, in a court of law, who knows? You know, he's talking to you, but who knows? You know? He doesn't have a birth certificate. He doesn't have parents. He doesn't have a social security number, you know?
But that doesn't mean it. It just means he's off the grid.
The rude and crude bear off the grid.
Mm-hmm. Want a brewski?
Yeah, yeah.
Don't tell the IRS about me. Marky Mark, I haven't paid taxes in years. Yeah, yeah. You're a bear. Get the taxes to pay. You don't own property. You live on my couch.
Your Marky Mark is so breathy.
He's breathy.
He's not as breathy as you make him out to be.
You gotta have lungs big to take out the 9/11 guys.
Mark, were you just jogging or something? You sound so out of breath.
I'm always jogging. I'm always doing a tiny little exercise with my feet.
Yeah, okay.
Gotta stay fit. I'm like 44. Gotta keep it tight.
Yeah, Mark. What's your workout plan? For your reps.
I sit around and I clench my feet. And I don't eat.
You don't eat at all?
Well, I don't eat, like, anything. I ate grapes.
You don't eat burgers? You eat your brother's burgers?
No, fuck that guy.
Whoa!
Yeah, he hated Ted. It's my fucking masterpiece movie. Hated Ted.
He hated Ted?
Yeah.
Did you invite him to be on Ted?
No, he's not an actor. He's a burger flipper. He'll dance. He'll do a dance.
Maybe he's a little jealous, you know? Maybe he wanted to be involved.
Maybe I wanted to be involved in his fucking burger thing. And so I was. You want something, you gotta take it.
See, it's you gotta make it a two-way street, Mark.
I'm from fucking Boston. Ain't no two-way streets there.
You were so out of breath. Are you okay? Are you, like, nervous?
I just can't beat a battle.
I gotta hang up. That got weird.
I fell into some spikes. It was really taxing.
Delilah just shared a incredible Seth MacFarlane tweet, which is, celebrate the legalization of same-sex marriage by going to see Ted 2 as he fights for his rights. And then there's a bear emoji.
That sounds like a Trump tweet. I hate that guy. I love the bear, I hate the guy.
Yes, love the bear, hate the guy.
Much better as a bear.
Really?
The bear's a kinder, gentle Seth MacFarlane.
You know, it seemed like you and the bear really got along in that movie.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and then they call cut, and then I'm like, it's just this fucking asshole. I believe in the mythos when it's on. When the cameras are on, I'm fully in the character. I've got a bear that's the best friend. Then there's just a fucking dude. I don't like it. Tricks me. Movies are nothing but weird tricks.
There's nothing but weird tricks?
Yeah.
Then why do you do them all the time?
I don't like to talk about this, but I'm addicted to lying.
You're addicted to lying?
Yeah, and to deception.
You think that acting is deception?
Yeah, I think it's necessarily dishonest.
I don't think that other people think that.
I don't think other people think like me.
Have you ever thought about, like, seeing someone?
Kind of enjoying the single life right now.
No, like... You know, like a therapist about your lying.
I don't think I could date a shrink.
God. I just like you so much.
Anyway, you should go to hayt.me and click the fucking thing. Here's a fun fact. Here's a fun behind the scenes. If you go to the site and you look at the support buttons, there's like a big immovable. I tried very hard to fix this a better way. But there's a big non-deletable like shopping cart picture, like a big gray shopping cart picture above each of the subscribe buttons. And the only way I could think to block it out was to put like a big white block there to just cover them. And it looks pretty good until you click the subscribe button for the first time,
and you can tell,
like, they're supposed to flip around and, like, tell you what you're buying, but that's covered by the block, and so you can tell something's wrong, you just can't tell what.
Also, wait, not only that, but if you, like, click the words, they, like, go up, and they just disappear.
Yeah. Well, it's hard to describe because you literally can't see what it's supposed to be happening, but like you can tell by the fact that the border around the edge disappears at the top. Because
uh-huh.
It used to be the edge of the gray shopping cart picture.
Right.
And instead of that disappears to display text that is now covered by a block.
Yeah, it's all you goofed it.
I goofed it. I didn't goof it. I think I did a really good job with some mediocre tools.
This is true.
Ah!
Whoa.
What?
Whoa. Are you alright?
Yeah, I was just doing one of the voices of a screaming man.
Okay. Alright.
Oh, I'm dead. Alright, let's stop this. I'm stopping this. Yeah. Quitting this. Quit. Quit.
Yeah.
Alright, thank you for watching, everybody. Remember that you should subscribe to contentburger.biz and then also to How Are You Today show. Mm-hmm. Here's a very important thing. If you're listening, fucking review that shit on iTunes, because I haven't had a review since August of 2015, because I haven't put out an episode since May of 2015. So it's like, yeah. I'm not complaining about that I haven't gotten any reviews because I haven't put out any episodes, but like, now is the choice time to write the review because I just got like, you know, hundreds and hundreds of downloads of the episodes. So if we could flashpoint that and get it into new and noteworthy, nothing will happen, but I'll feel good about it. So do that, and then go to hayt.me and look at that it's cute, and subscribe to that too.
You should also subscribe to Friends of the Table.
Yeah, while you're on iTunes, subscribe to and review Friends of the Table.
That's... Yeah, we're number 21 on Games and Hobbies right now.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I mean, that's because that show is almost embarrassingly well-received, so...
Almost embarrassingly well received.
Yeah, at some point, just like, all right, guys, come on.
We get that you like it. Like, just calm down. Yeah. It's fine. It's,
Like, I cried. Like, yeah, okay.
Just
so did Allie. Cool, I'm not impressed.
Fuck you.
No, that's not true. Don't listen. I cry at literally everything. So all someone has to do.
You literally never cried on that show.
No, not on that show. Because I don't cry at things that happen to me. All somebody has to do is have a sentiment, and I'll cry. Like, not a lot, but like a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, if you have a point of view and a mournful, story, like, not like a sentence, like a thing, like if somebody in a song says like I miss this person, I'll be like, oh.
Okay.
It's not serious, aww, but it's definitely distracting. I was listening to. I just had the Mountain Goats on shuffle, and what's the new album? What's the new one? The wrestling one?
Oh, I don't know.
It's
but
the wrestling one.
I know what you're
one.
Talking about. Yeah.
And I don't even like that album. I don't even like it. And it was the title. It was not that. It was the leading track. The one about Chavo Guerrero. And
yeah.
There was just like one sentence where, and I was just like, oh, I'm tearing up at this. And I don't even care about that song or that. It's my one of my least favorite Mountain Goats albums.
It's tough. Sometimes it gets you.
It is, yep. Chavo Guerrero, it's his last hope.
I know, it's tough.
It's very tough.
Anyway, let's
beat the champ. There we go. That's
popsicle stands. Yeah.
Yep. Yes. All right, see ya. Go to the sites, fuckdads.com too. Listen, it's like I'm covering all my bases. Thanks for watching.